Hey there, tech enthusiast. Now the first step is installing the XCP-ng as the hypervisor.
Hyper what? Let me show you. Imagine this stove is your computer and that box with X is your storage for operating systems. Normally it's one computer, one operating system.
Right.
Wrong. You can install multiple operating systems as virtual machines on the same computer or server as long as it supports virtualization technology. You asking me how? By using the hypervisor. In this case I'm not frying egg directly on the stovetop, right? But using the frying pan, our hypervisor, to fry slash install few of them at the same time. Got it? Get it? Good.
To install Hypervisor, we need to download it first. Now we're going to the XCP-ng website. With a quick click of the download button, we're directed to the latest version of XCP-ng version 8.2 as of May of 2023. As the download begins, we take a moment to appreciate the ease simplicity of this process. But wait, there is more! We're going to download Rufus from the same page. How cool is that? Also need a USB flash drive with at least 1 GB of storage memory from which we will boot up Hypervisor installation. My flash drive has 128 gigs, which is a little bit overkill. Why not? In order to get our bootable USB flash drive ready, I will use the Rufus. Alright, let's start our installation. First, we're gonna fire up Rufus software. There we are. Then you see the my flash drive that just showed up over here in the list. Then over here, I'm gonna select just downloaded XCP-ng ISO file and just hit start. It offers me to write it as ISO image mode. That's recommended and I'm gonna go with that. Now it's giving me a warning that all data on the device will be destroyed. Fine by me. Now I'm gonna let it do its thing. Ready. Now we're gonna plug it in this USB as the bootable drive to Lenovo. Alright, we're gonna boot it up from a USB drive, what I have by default, and install XCP-ng. In this menu, we're gonna choose the keyboard layout. For me, it's US, QWERTY. Over here, we're just gonna hit OK. This accepting the end user license agreement. Alright, so I have two drives installed, and this is my flash drive. So that I'll be installing it on this drive, which is the first one right here. And for the virtual machines, I'm gonna choose this drive only, and I'll remove this one as well, because I don't wanna have it on the bootable drive. Okay, the select installation source is gonna be from the flash drive, or it's called the local media. It'll be looking for files. It's gonna ask you if you wanna verify the installation source. Why not? It'll take maybe a minute or two. It's not much. Alright, it says verification of your installation. XCP-ng complete successfully. No problems were found. Continue. Okay, now it's time to put super secret password. Repeat it again. Which network interface would you like to use for connecting to the management server on your host? So this one is here as a separate. I'm gonna use it for WAN for ISP provider. So for management interface, I'm gonna use this one, the port 1. On the 4-port card. All right, over here, I'm gonna use the static IP address, and I'm gonna do it very generic. Lab 1.168.1.21. At this point, and over here, I'm gonna call it server, XCP-ng server. DNS record will be also 192.168.1.1, but I will reconfigure it once I have the IPF sense and other virtual machines. All right, so region, select the time zone. I'm gonna use America.
America.
And the closest to me will be New York, right here. Since I don't have an internet connection right now, it's not plugged into anywhere, so I'm gonna use manual time entry. And right now I'm hitting install XCP-ng. It just told that it's gonna destroy all the old data from those drives. The installation process will take some time though. Right, so now it's prompting us, would you like to install any supplemental packs? Says no, and it's about to complete the installation. All right, so it says the XCP-ng install has completed. Please remove all local media from the drive and press enter to reboot. So I'm gonna hit reboot, remove the USB drive stick, and we should be good to go. All right, let's boot it up and actually see if it's got installed correctly. Finally, we are in game. So now time is to configure it and get few virtual machines running. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, give me a thumbs up. share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe on my channel.